Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. حي على السلام حي على حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين الذين آتيناهم الكتاب يتلونه حق تلاوته أولئك يؤمنون به ومن يكفر به فأولئك هم الخاسرون
Nowadays, by the grace of Allah, mashallah, while because of Ramadan, in order to listen to Darsul Quran and the recitation of the Quran, translation and some points of commentary, while these opportunities are available and many people benefit from these opportunities with great interest and also at the time of Namaz-e-Taraweeh, one full recitation of the Holy Quran is made and a large number of people also benefits from this facility. While at homes as well, the reading of the Holy Quran and doing its recitation and tilawat and also learning its meaning, many people have this opportunity of doing so. Generally speaking, mashallah, most of the people, most of the Ahmadis, they pay special attention to the reading and the tilawat of the Holy Quran at homes. One reason of that, Hazur says, is that because of the holy month of Ramadan, every believer tries in a general way to create a spiritual improvement in oneself. And secondly, the Holy Quran, as we know, has got a special link with the holy month of Ramadan. The revelation started in this very month, and the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam apne huzur munajat ko Khuda Taala ne suna, and Allah Almighty listened to the supplications of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and opened the gates of his mercy. And and after seeing the whole world into the grip of adultery and filth,
Allah Almighty chose this blessed person, the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, in order to reform the world, and he gave him the last book of Sharia, and he was appointed as such. And then during the long period of over 23 years, this revelation continued to came down, and every year Hazrat Jibrail would come down and repeat along with the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam that portion that had been revealed until that time. And in this way, one complete reading of that much of the Quran was completed. And the year in which the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam passed away, in that when the holy month of Ramadan came, then in that month, when the Sharia was completed and perfected, and twice the full reading of the Holy Quran was made during that month. Therefore, this is a tradition which are continued by the believers and should be continued. And at least once or twice, one full reading of the Holy Quran is made by them. And those who can afford, they can read it more than twice. But it should not be read very quickly, that in such a way that you don't understand what you are reciting. The Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, his companions, those who knew the language, they were Arabs. Even the instruction to them from the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was that who finished the full reading of the Quran within less than 3 days, then it will be as if he has not understood the message of the Holy Quran. In one tradition, 7 days are also mentioned. So these companions of the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, they had their different abilities, and according to that, the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to advise them according to their capabilities. But the main purpose, the fundamental purpose, is that the Holy Quran should be recited, and you should ponder over its meanings, and you should ponder over the teachings which are given, and then make them a part of your life. And if you read and recite, if you don't recite the Holy Quran in this way, then it's not of much use. The companions, they understood this point very well, and they understood the way how the Holy Quran should be recited. Therefore, Allah Almighty has testified that they really did full justice to the recitation of the Holy Quran, as in this verse which I just recited. Allah Almighty says in this verse that those people who were given book by us, they recite it in such a way as is due, as it should be. And these are the people who actually have full faith in it, and whosoever denies that, those are the people who are the losers. So these were the people through the noble example and the spiritual effect of the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and Allah Almighty made these people a God-fearing people, and those people who reflected the glory of Allah, how they used to do the full justice to the recitation. Was it simply by reciting the words of the Quran? No, not like that. There are certain requirements which they have to fulfill, and there are certain conditions which they have to comply, and it is essential to comply those conditions. The first thing is that as during the month of Ramadan nowadays, almost every one of us, he gets up early in the morning and he offers the nawafil, and after that, having his sehri, sahur, to start his fast, and then he goes for prayer. If time permits, there is a time in between Nawafil and Sehri. Some people recite the Quran in between if the time permits. And in Nawafil, the Holy Quran, which if somebody has memorized, that is generally recited. And also after the prayer, the recitation of the Holy Quran, Tilawat, is made after that. In every house, generally, they do the effort, have the effort, make the effort to do this recitation, because this is a time in which one can increase, make progress in spirituality. It's a special time. So therefore, this precedent and this system and this practice should continue even after the end of Ramadan. We may not be keeping fast after Ramadan, but the Nawafil, the prayer, the recitation of the Holy Quran, and getting up early at appointed time, and all these things should be done even after the month of Ramadan. Allah Almighty has mentioned in the Holy Quran the importance of the recitation of the Holy Quran at the time of Fajr. Wa Quran al-Fajr is the wording used there, that you give importance to the recitation of the in the Holy Quran at that time. And then it says, Inna Quran al-Fajr kana mashhuda, that this recitation at the time of Fajr is the one which stands as the witness. So these things become the source of forgiveness for people. But is it only enough that people should simply recite in order to get all the blessings of this world and the hereafter? And Hazur says it is not enough that we should simply do like that, but we should understand the portion that we have recited. That is the reason why the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he spoke to one of his companion Abdullah bin Amr. He said, perhaps I have mentioned this thing before as well, but the detailed narration is like this, that you complete one full reading in 1 month, so that gradually when you read the verses, then you ponder over it, think over it, go to the deeper meanings, and they will dawn upon you. That when he said, but when he said that I have got enough time and I have got the ability that I can recite more, then the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that you can complete in 1 week, but not more than that. So the Holy Prophet ﷺ wanted to make this thing very clear to his companions, that only the recitation, just the reading of the Holy Quran is not enough. Sometimes people do it very quickly, and maybe in 10 or 11 hours one can complete the full reading, but one will not be able to understand anything at all. I have mentioned it before, that some people who lead the Taraweeh prayer, those who have memorized the whole Quran, they recite in such way that nobody understands what they are saying. In our Jamaat, perhaps in our Jamaat, there is hardly anybody who is like that. But the non-Ahmadis in their mosque, they in 20 minutes or 30 minutes, they recite one full spara, and also the 20 rakats they also complete. So I wonder if they could understand anything at all during this short period. There is ability in everyone, and there is a style for everyone to recite the Holy Quran. Some people can recite quickly and with clear wording, with clear expression, and some people read it slowly. But we are told that we should recite the Holy Quran, do the tilawat in a way that we are able to understand it. In the Holy Quran, Allah Almighty says, وَرَتَّلِ الْقُرْآنَ تَرْتِيلًا, that you recite the Holy Quran very clearly. Now, the one who is going to lead the prayer in 20 or 30 minutes, the Taraweeh prayer Hazur is mentioning, and he has to complete one part of the Quran, then how he would be able to understand and how he will be able to make it clear for other people? Once Hazur says, I went somewhere with someone else, and early in the morning, when we finished the Tilawat in the morning, and then the person told me that He said, I did not expect this thing from you. And he said, I thought perhaps I have made a mistake. He said, you were reciting the Holy Quran. I have been seeing you recite it very slowly. It means that perhaps you don't know how to read it very well. Hazur says that I told him that this is my habit. Everybody has his own way of reciting. And I did not know the reference of this hadith at that time, and the verse did not occur to me at that time. But I told him that I can recite very quickly. You can compete with me in that. But I recite the way I enjoy. And the purpose of all this statement is that some people, in order to show their scholarly ability, they try to read it very quickly, while Allah Almighty and His Messenger is saying that you should recite in such a way that you understand it, and this is the best way of doing it. And as I said, everybody has his own ability, capacity is limited, different, and everybody has his own way of his own speed and the ability of his picking up the meaning. So according to that, it should be there. And generally, the Holy Quran should be recited while you are understanding its meaning. And this is also in line with the respect for the Holy Quran. Even if you know the meaning very well, still it is better to recite the Holy Quran slowly, gradually, understanding the meaning, so that you are able to enlighten your mind more with the teachings of the Holy Quran. And when you, but if somebody understands that I have got the knowledge, but Hazur says that in order, after understanding of the Holy Quran, then this standard does not remain there all the time. Therefore, according to one's ability, one should do so. There are some very clear commandments in the Holy Quran, and it's very essential to act upon those things after understanding. The advice can only benefit when you listen to those words of advice and then act accordingly. One purpose of one meaning of the word tilawat is also to follow it. The Holy Quran, Allah Almighty says in the Holy Quran that I have revealed this Holy Quran, and I have revealed it for you and for everybody who wants to rise to higher stages of understanding and faith. Then these higher stages, in order to achieve that, all the rules and regulations and principles are made very clear for all the people of different abilities. And not only this much, Hazur says that, as I said, that all these levels are for different people, and there is an advice for all the people. There is advice for everyone according to one's his ability. Allah Almighty says, وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِن مُدَّكِرٍ. And surely we have, for the purpose of advice, made this Quran much easy for everyone. Is there anyone who would care to get this advice? Therefore, it's up to us that how much do we impose or bring this teaching upon us and act upon it and take benefit from this advice. Therefore, it's the duty of every Ahmadi today during this month of Ramadan. They should recite the Holy Quran, which is full of wisdom, and we should try to live according to the teachings of the Holy Quran. We should act upon each and every commandment that is given to us, and which we are supposed to act upon that. And whatever Allah Almighty has made it unlawful, we should try to avoid all those things. And Huzur says that we should never be among those people about whom the Holy Quran says that وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبِّ إِنَّا قَوْمِ اتَّخَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ مَحْجُورًا. And the messenger will say, it means that my people have abandoned this Holy Quran. This period is exactly the same period which is mentioned here, when there are so many other interests as well, so many attractions for people, there are so many other books which people would like to read, and there are other attractions, means of attraction, internet is there. Sometimes people sit the whole night in front of it like addiction, and there are other interests like that, attractions like that, and there are so many thoughts and philosophies which are there, which are generally taking the people away from religion. And the Muslims are also, the whole Muslim society is, as a matter of fact, in the grip of that. So therefore, by ignoring the teachings of the Holy Quran and following the things they like, this is the age of the promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam. And this is the time when the Holy Quran speaks that the people have neglected the teachings of the Holy Quran. So it is Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam, the promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam, who has to introduce this teaching of the Quran, which has been abandoned by the people. And this was his mission, and he did this. He did accomplish this mission. Nowadays, it is our responsibility, the responsibility of all of us Ahmadis. It is the responsibility of each and every Ahmadi today that he should not only act upon the teachings of the Holy Quran, he should make himself subject to this teaching, but he should also preach it to other people and convey it to other people. And he should further support and expand the mission of the promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam. And this verse which I have just recited before you, this should never be reflecting the attitude of any Ahmadi at all. And this sentence of the promised Messiah should always be in our minds, that those people who will honor the Holy Quran, they will be honored in heaven. We should be honoring each and every word and each and every letter of the Holy Quran. And the honor will be given when actually we are acting upon that. And when we will be doing like that, then the Holy Quran will deliver us from each and every anxiety, and that will become like an umbrella for us. As the Allah Almighty says in this verse, and it means that we reveal in the Holy Quran, which is a source of cure, and it increases the Muslims in faith and the disbelievers in disbelief and loss. Therefore, it is our responsibility that while we do the tilawat of the Holy Quran, the recitation, then we should be always keep in mind all the do's and don'ts mentioned in the Holy Quran, and we should act upon this teaching of the Holy Quran. And we should make it a part of our lives, and only then we will be able to get the spiritual and physical cure which is promised in the Holy Quran. And those who don't act upon the teachings of the Holy Quran, they are the wrongdoers. And as mentioned in the Holy Quran, and their eyes are, as a matter of fact, blind, and the Holy Quran does not give them any benefit at all. There are so many books and against Islam. Some of them are non-Muslims, they are Christians. Sometimes they write something very good about the noble character of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. One writer is Karen Armstrong. This writer has quoted in his book. The writer says that that there is nothing which we should This is not some, there is nothing in the Holy Quran on which the society can base. This only gives the weapons, and they suppress every thought which is against their belief, and then writes that the subject matter is very limited, which narrows the mind and thinking. So the Holy Quran, Huzur says, has already made this claim regarding these people and regarding those people who are not going to be guided to the right path, that it gives guidance to those people who have got some element of piety in their heart, or they have some inclination to going towards the right path. Everybody has his own standard of piety, whether they are Muslims or not. So, but this is also a form of taqwa, that they should try to see the right things. So the Holy Quran is a source of guidance for those people who have got pure mind, those who are righteous people. But those who are looking with the eyes of biased eyes and influenced thought, then Allah Almighty, He says that this Quran will not be able to give any guidance to those people. And these biased people, those who talk in these terms, they are the opponents. And Allah Almighty says that for them, there is a total loss, which is the lot of these people. As Allah Almighty says, وَلَا يَزِيدُ ظَالِمِينَ إِلَّا خَسَارًا. It does not increase those people except in their state of loss. So now Huzur says it is the responsibility of Ahmadi that in this age, they should do the tilawat of the Holy Quran in this age, and also they should act upon the teachings of the Holy Quran, and they should make the Holy Quran as a part of their life, so that through this action of theirs, through the action of each and every Ahmadi, these transgressors, they should be made speechless. Hazrat Masih Maud says that you ponder over the teachings of the Holy Quran, everything is therein. It gives the details of the good things and the bad things, the news about the future, and you understand it fully, that these are the presented in such a way that nobody can object to that one, because the fruits and the blessings of the Holy Quran are fresh and new, and these things are not to be found in the other religious books like Bible. And these teachings in other books may be appropriate to the times in which it was revealed, but not to all times. This is only the honor of the Holy Quran, that Allah Almighty has spoken about the cure of every ill, and everything Allah Almighty has made very clear. Therefore, you should go on reciting the Holy Quran, do its tilawat, and you should make your way of living according to the teachings of the Holy Quran. Now I would like to present some ahadith of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in which the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has mentioned the blessings of reciting the Holy Quran. Hazrat Abdullah bin Masood radhiyallahu ta'ala anhu narrates that the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that whosoever read one word of the Holy Quran, he would get one virtue. And as a result of one virtue, he will get 10 virtues. And I don't mean to say that Alif Lam Mim is one word, but Alif is one word, and Lam is one word, and Mim is one word. And in another narration, Hazrat Aisha Siddiqa radiallahu ta'ala anha narrates that the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the one who recites the Holy Quran, does its tilawat, and likes it, and he loves to do so, and he is among the obedient and honorable people. Hazrat Abdullah bin Masood radiallahu ta'ala anhu says that the one who recited 50 verses of the Holy Quran in one day, he should not be counted among unmindful people. And another narration says that if somebody recited in one night 50 verses of the Quran, he should be counted among those people who have memorized the Holy Quran. And regarding the status of these people who have memorized the Holy Quran by heart, the hadith tells us narrated by Hazrat Abu Sayyid Khudri, that the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the Hafiz of Quran will be asked when you enter into the paradise, that you go on reciting the Quran and go on increasing the higher stages in paradise. So he will do like that, because as a result of each verse that he recites, there will be a higher stage for him promised in paradise. And he will continue rising higher and higher up in the paradise. Then regarding the recitation of the Holy Quran in the houses on a regular basis, Allah Almighty, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that you in your homes you recite the Holy Quran extensively. That house is in which the Holy Quran is not recited, the blessing is reduced and the vice increases in that house, and that house becomes narrow for those people who are living therein. So therefore every Ahmadi should remember this instruction of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and during this month of Ramadan every member of the family he should try to get this blessing of Allah Almighty by recitation of the Holy Quran. They should continue doing so, and as a result of this blessing, not only the blessings, they will be improving their life, this life and the life to come, but also they will also be getting strength to defend against the onslaught of Satan. But they should remember that these blessings are only to be achieved at a time when you are understanding what you are reciting and you are acting upon what you learn from the Holy Quran. Otherwise it will be something like the blind people, as I have mentioned earlier on. Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam has also mentioned that in order to get this blessing, you have to recite the Holy Quran and you should pray to Allah, and also make your conduct subservient to this teaching. And how the recitation, the tilawat should be done, about that Hazrat Bara bin Azib narrates from the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that he said that that you increase the beauty of the Holy Quran by your melodious voice. Hazrat Masih Maud alaihi salatu wasalam says that the real essence of worship is the recitation of the Quran. When you read this letter of the Blessed, then it creates a great fountain of love in your heart, and there is a heat generated in your heart, the heat of love of Allah. So if you claim to have the love of Allah Almighty, then you should try to increase this love more. And in order to do that, you have to recite the Holy Quran with full understanding, and we should also act upon the teachings, and this thing is very essential, Hazur says. And Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam says, somebody asked a question, in reply to that he said that the Holy Quran should be recited with pondering over its meaning and thinking over it by reflecting upon its contents. Hadith says the hadith of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that there are many such people. There would be many such people who would be reciting the Holy Quran, but the Holy Quran will be invoking curse upon those people. And those are such people who read the Quran but do not act upon that. So when the verses of the Holy Quran are there in which the mercy of Allah Almighty is mentioned, one should seek the blessing. And when the punishment of Allah is mentioned, that one should seek protection against the wrath of Allah and the punishment. So one should always read the Holy Quran with the proper thinking, and one should be acting upon that. Huzur says this is the right way of the recitation and the tilawat. And then Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam further says
नहीं
Huzoor says that not the writing of the promised Messiah, but there is a hadith. Hazrat Abu Amama Bahli narrates this one, that I heard the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say that when you recite the Holy Quran, then the Holy Quran will be doing this intercession on your behalf on the Day of Judgment. And this Surah Baqarah and Surah Fatiha, they should be like the beautiful roses. You recite those, and these things will be presented at the time on the Day of Judgment, and these will be defending those people who have been reciting these verses, and they will be giving evidence in their support. And moreover, it's mentioned that you recite Surah Baqarah and act upon that. It is useful for you, and nobody can deny that, and nobody can stand against that. So it means that the subject matter of Surah Baqarah should be understood properly, and you should act upon that. You can understand quite a lot from that. No one should take it in that sense that the recitation of the rest of the Quran is not essential. These are the only two chapters which should be recited. But the fact of the matter is that depending on the subject matter of these two chapters, and in importance of acting upon that, this thing has been mentioned. And also try to memorize it and recite part of these two chapters in your Nawafil, especially at the Nawafil time. And it is mentioned in one hadith that one companion, when he got up in the middle of the night, he saw the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam offering the Nawafil prayer. He also joined with him. And after a while, he said that I felt too much tired. And the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam recited Surah Baqarah, all of it, and then in second rakat maybe Ali Imran, Surah Ali Imran. And just see, Huzoor says that what was the used to be the style of the recitation of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He must have felt tired, the other person, because the narration tells us that the recitation of the Holy Quran, the tilawat, one, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to be in a special feelings. And regarding Surah Baqarah, he has mentioned that this is the as if the pinnacle of the Holy Quran, the peak of the Holy Quran. And various subjects are mentioned in Surah Baqarah, starting from Hazrat Adam up to the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Various prophets are mentioned, the worship is mentioned, the prayer is mentioned, the psalm, the fasting is mentioned. Similarly, other commandments are there. Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam, Hazrat Ismail alayhi salam, their prayers are also mentioned. And similarly, other prayers have been taught in this chapter. In Ali Imran, there are other subjects as well about Hazrat Isa and about the wars of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Battle of Badr is also mentioned, and some other defensive battles. So there is a treasure of knowledge in these chapters. And according to another narration, it is mentioned regarding the excellence of reading and memorizing the Holy Quran. Hazrat Aisha Siddiqa radhiyallahu ta'ala anha says that the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that reading the Holy Quran in prayer is of great excellence. It is that recitation in the prayer is much more rewarding and beneficial than the one which is recited elsewhere. And reciting the Holy Quran is much better in the Holy Quran than doing other prayers. And glorifying Allah Almighty is much better than giving something as charity. And Some people, when they do it with proper thinking, then it is better than sadqa. And roza is better than sadqa. And roza, the fasting, is like a shield in order to get protection from the punishment of fire. And the recitation in the, during the prayer, because the prayer is offered in a special mood, in a special feelings. So therefore, at that time, the recitation of Holy Quran is of great blessing. Whenever Allah Almighty has warned us against something, or He has mentioned about these things, so one has to do istighfar at that time. And then one can really understand that as if I am standing before Allah. And regarding the prayer, Allah Almighty says that we should do it in such a way as if you are standing before Allah. So therefore it is mentioned that the recitation of the Holy Quran during the prayer is much more rewarding and beneficial. And also another benefit is that you are reminded of this responsibility of memorizing more and more of the Holy Quran, that is full of blessings. But anyway, Huzur says that generally there are the recitation of the Holy Quran in a general way is much better than doing so many other good things. Hazrat Masih Maud says that the Holy Quran is such a pure book, holy book, that it came at a time when the world was filled with so many vices and problems, and so many incorrect things were there, and misconduct so rampant at that time. And referring to this state, the Holy Allah Almighty mentions in this word, Zahar al-Fasadu fil barri wal bahr, that all the people, whether people of the book or other people, they all these people, they were completely surrounded by vices. And at that time, in order to refute all the wrong beliefs, Allah Almighty revealed such a wonderful book like the Holy Quran for our guidance, which has got the refutation of all the wrong religions, and especially the Surah Fatiha. Allah Almighty has mentioned to all these wrong beliefs in Surah Fatiha. And He says that another important instruction for you, that you should never abandon the Holy Quran. This is actually a source of your life. Those who will honor the Holy Quran, they will be honored in heaven. Those who would prefer the Holy Quran upon every hadith or any other thing, they will be given preference in heaven. For the mankind on the surface of the earth, there is no other book except the Holy Quran. And for the whole of mankind, for all the people, there is no other prophet or intercessor except the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, I tell you honestly that if you do not turn your face away from the Holy Quran, from the meaning point or the from pointing of its word, then Allah Almighty will make a distinction between those people who are loved by Allah and others. And the full faith in Allah is created as a result of the Holy Quran. And you are able to witness the wonders of the glory of Allah Almighty. The person, his prayers are accepted. And he is given such spiritual faculties that he is able to see the wonders of Allah Almighty as the other people are unable to see. And he listens to such things and sees such things which are not seen by other people. So in order to get your prayers accepted, it is very essential to recite the Holy Quran. May Allah, Huzur says that as if perhaps 17 days of fast are already over, so may Allah enable us in the remaining few days of Ramadan, may Allah enable us to get these blessing of the Holy Quran more than before. We should read it, we should recite it, and we should act upon it. And that is only possible when we analyze ourselves on a daily basis. And we should find out how much benefit we have acquired from the Holy Quran. And we should also make up our mind that until the last day of Ramadan, whatever we have achieved from the Holy Quran by way of blessings, then we should try to make it a part of our life. This practice of reciting the Holy Quran, doing the tilawat during the month of Ramadan, this should be continued even after the month of Ramadan. And we should be we should be trying to understand it and act according to that one in ordinary days after the Ramadan. We should have an eye on our houses, and we should supervise that our wives and children, they are also reciting the Quran and acting upon the teachings of the Holy Quran. May Allah enable all of us to do so, that we are the one who received the blessings of the Holy Quran and continue to.
Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruhu wa nu'minu bihi wa natawakkalu alayhi wa na'uzu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina man yahdihillahu fala mudilla lahu wa man yudlilhu fala hadiya lahu ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل واللسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر.